Discussing about whether a given decomposition is functional dependency preserving or not. So in this video, let us take a few more examples of functional dependency preserving decompositions. Okay, so assuming that we have the following relation, which is R A B C D. This is the relation which is given, and the functional dependencies which are given, they are like this: A determines B, B determines C, C determines D, and D determines A. Now they are saying this given relation is broken down into three relations, or you can say the given relation is decomposed into the three relations. Number one, R1 with attributes AB. Number two, R2 with attributes BC. Number three, R3 with attributes CD. So we have these three decompositions of the given relation. Now, first of all, before we are checking whether decomposition is functional dependency preserving or not, first of all check whether this decomposition is lossless or not. So if the decomposition is not lossless, then we'll not even check whether it is functional dependency preserving or not. So you can say in the case of R1 and R2, R1 is having the attribute AB and R2 is having the attribute BC. In R1 and R2, the common attribute is B and B. Now you can see, because of this functional dependency which is given, we can say that B is at least a key attribute in this relation. Therefore, R1 and R2 is a lossless decomposition. Now if you combine R1 and R2, then you are going to get A, B, C as attributes, and we have the relation R3 which is CD. Now here the common attribute is C, therefore at least C should be a key attribute in one of the table, and because of this function dependency, we can say C is a key attribute here. Okay, now we'll come back to this and we'll see whether a decomposition is this decompositions are lossless or not. So see, here we have two attributes, here we have two attributes, here we have two attributes. Now how will you check whether what are the additional functional dependencies which are valid for this? For these two attributes, there are what are the functional dependencies which are possible? They are A determines phi, A determines B, B determines A, and B determines phi. These are the functional dependencies which can be there, but you have to say out of these functional dependencies which are valid. Okay, how am I taking this functional dependency? Is for these attributes A and B, what are the subsets of A and B are possible? The subset can be phi, A, B, and AB. These are the four subsets possible for A and B. Again, in the second way also, you have to take these four subsets, that is phi, A, B, AB. Now you can combine this. Phi can determine phi, phi can determine A, phi can determine B, and phi can determine AB. Then A can determine phi, A can determine A, A can determine B, A can determine AB. Again, B can determine phi, B can determine A, B can determine B, and B can determine AB. Again, AB can determine phi, AB can determine A, AB can determine B, and AB can determine AB. Now here, out of these, some of them are actually not trivial, like A can determine A itself, AB can determine A, AB can determine B, AB can determine AB, or AB can determine phi. These are trivial functional dependencies. So we are not going to discuss about the trivial functional dependencies. We have to see out of these functional dependencies what are valid. So the first one is valid because it is already trivial, so no need of taking this. Second one, A determines B. This A determines B exists in the original functional dependency, therefore it is valid. Third one is B determines A. How can you say B determine A is valid? If in the original functional dependencies, you take B closure and you get A in B closure, then you can say B determines A is also valid. So B closure is B, C, D, A. So here in B closure, we are getting A, therefore this functional dependency is also valid, and this is also trivial. So no need of writing the trivial functional dependencies. So A determines B is valid and B determines A is valid. Right. So again, for R2, let us find the functional dependencies which are not trivial, that is B determines C and C determines B. Out of these functional dependencies, you can clearly see B determines C is already given here, therefore it is valid, and we have to say whether C determines B or not. That means to say this one, in the original functional dependencies, take C closure, and what are the attributes you can get in C closure. C closure will give you C, D, A, B. So in C closure we are getting B, therefore C determines B is also valid functional dependency. Okay, now in R3, C determines D and D determines C. These are the two functional dependencies which are possible. Now C determines D is already given, but we have to identify whether D determines C is valid or not. to say whether determine C is valid, in original table take D closure. So in D closure we are getting A, B, C, D, and because we are getting C, therefore this is also a valid functional dependencies. Okay, so what are the sets? We are having three sets. This is representing the set F1, which is having the functional dependencies A determine B and B determine A. We have the set F2 here, which is representing B determines C and C determines B. We have the set F3, which is C determines D and D determines C. So these are the three sets. Now how can you see this decomposition is functional dependency preserving? If we take F1 union F2 union F3 closure, then it should be equivalent to original F closure. Okay, that means these should cover these. Okay, in the same way these should cover these. If they cover each other, then we can say these two functional dependencies are these are functional dependency preserving. So if we do F1 union F2 union F3, then what are the functional dependencies we can get? That is A determines B. Next we are getting B determines A. Next B determines C. Next C determines B. Next C determines D. Next D determines C. These are the functional dependencies we can get with this. Now what is F? F is representing A determines B, B determines C, C determines D and D determines A. Now out of all this, this is already present here, so no problem. Already present here, so no problem. And D determines A, we have to see whether D determines A or not. So to see whether D determines A, we can check. How can you check? We already given that D determines C and C determines B, right? And B determines A. Therefore, we can say D determines A by transitive functional dependency. So this is also covered here. In the same way, we have to check whether this functional dependency B determines A is covered here or not. You can see here again transitively it is covering, and this is also covering transitively. Therefore this decomposition is FD preserving. This decomposition is functional dependency preserving. Okay, now let us take the next example.